Hello, welcome to my first Greenfoot lesson at MrStewartsLessons.com. So what we're going to do is we're going to make a little game here in using the Greenfoot program. You should already have the Greenfoot program on your computer. If you don't have that, you can go to greenfoot.org and you can find the download link there at greenfoot.org, and you can download the program. But I'm not going to do that right now. I assume you already have the program. What I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to download the demo that I've created for this lesson. And so to download the demo, what you're going to do is you're going to put in this link here, which is bit.ly, capital G, lowercase z, capital A, capital R, capital H, number 6. You can see it right there. You're going to go there and it's going to download a program for you. You're going to have to unzip the program and you're going to have to open that program in Greenfoot. I'm not going to do that in this demo because that is different in every computer, and where the folders are different in every computer. So if you need to know how to do that, you can look that up on the Greenfoot site to see how it's done. So you're going to have to download the program and then download this link and then open up the demo in Greenfoot. So do that right now and then come back, and you're going to and when it's open in Greenfoot, and I'll show you what to do next. Okay, so if you got the program open, what you're going to see here is something that looks like this. If you see a gray screen here, you don't see the sand on the ground of the gold buggy world. What you should do is click this compile button. We're going to use that compile button a lot. The compile button is what makes the program, puts the program into a language so the computer can run it. So what we're looking at here is this is the world where everything in the video game is going to happen once we make it. Over to the side here, what you see are what we call our classes. A class is a kind of thing that you can put into your program, a kind of thing that you can use to create objects that do things in your program. Two kinds of classes that we see a lot in Greenfoot. One is called a world class. Usually there's only one world class per game. In this case, it's Gold Buggy World. Mostly what the world class does is it just tells you how big the screen is and what goes on the background for now. Later on, it can do more. And then you have actor classes. Actor classes are the things that happen on the screen, the things that move around, the things that do things on the screen, or sometimes just sit there. In this case, we have one actor that's called the gold buggy, and that's the little buggy that's going to drive around and find gold. So what we're going to do, first thing we can do is put one of the gold buggies, into the program. When we put it in, we're creating what's called an object. An object is an instance of the gold buggy, and so you'll see this little gold buggy. I can click here and I can do new gold buggy and I can put it down. If I click there, you'll see a gold buggy will appear and I can put it down wherever I want, like right there. Another way I can do this, if I press the shift key, so you'll see if I'm holding down the shift key, buggies will appear on under my mouse. I can just drop them wherever I want. I can drop buggies wherever I want. These buggies are little objects that can do things in the game, except right now they can't really do much of anything. If I try and run the game, if I click run, they would do whatever they're programmed to do, but right now they're not programmed to do anything, so they're just going to sit there. I made them so that they weren't programmed to do anything, so you can do the programming. So I'll click pause. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to want to add some code to the Gold Buggy class, and that code that I add to the Gold Buggy class is going to be part of every Gold Buggy I put on the game. So I'm going to double click on the Gold Buggy class, and I'm going to see that there's nothing on there, just so you can see that there's no code. Before I do anything, I'd like you to try and put down some gold buggies on your screen. So you can try clicking with the right mouse button, add a new gold buggy, or you can click on it and then hold down the shift key and drop a couple of gold buggies on the screen. So pause it and do that now. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to make my gold buggy so it can actually do something. I'll make it so it can move. We'd like it to be able to move. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to double click on the gold buggy, and that's going to open up the image, the editor. The editor is what allows me to edit the code. You'll notice the main thing that's in the center of the screen is public void act. The act is what the gold buggy would do it when I run the game. It's what the gold buggy normally does, and you'll see that there's it, that's what it says right here. This part here, this blue part, all the blue part is the comments. The public class gold buggy extends vehicle. This is, we don't need to know what all those words mean. The main thing we need to understand is this is a big block of code that says what the gold buggy's like, and this bracket up here is what starts it, and this bracket down here is what ends it. And then inside this gold buggy class, we have the act, which is what's called a method. A method is something that an object can do, and in this case, it's what it does all the time as the game is running. So anything I put inside this act method, it's going to just keep doing over and over again as long as the game's running. So what I'm going to do down here is I'm going to click inside there. You may see a comment or something that says click here, a comment that you just delete. Anything that's inside here, you should just delete it. And then I want to see what kind of things I can put in here, what kind of methods I can put in here. One nice thing I can do is if I press Control Space, I'll see all of the methods that are available to put inside here. And these are all the methods that I can put inside my gold buggy. Now you may wonder, where do these methods come from? Well, gold buggy is a subclass of two other classes. It's a subclass of vehicle, and that is a subclass of the actor class. The actor and the vehicle class have some things built into them that they can do, some methods that I can get from them and put them into my gold buggy class. The one we're looking for is the one that says move. That's going to make the gold buggy move. So if you look down, they're all in alphabetical order. So we're going to look for move int. And you notice this says void over here. And the void means that it's a method that does something but doesn't return any information. It doesn't give any kind of information back. Sometimes we're going to get information back, and I'll explain that later. But right now, it's just it not returning anything. It's just going to make something happen. One way to think about this would be, for example, if you press the accelerate pedal on your car, it makes the car go forward, but it doesn't return any information to you. Or the brake will make the car stop. It doesn't return anything to you, though. And you'll notice inside the move, it says INT. INT stands for integer. Integer is a positive or negative whole number. This is what's called the argument. The move wants to know how much it's going to move. So what goes in parentheses, the integer in parentheses, is going to tell me how much it's going to move. I can put it in right here by double clicking. You'll see in highlight it says distance. So this is the distance, how much it wants to move, and it's in pixels. One pixel is pretty small, so one pixel isn't very much. Let's make it move 5 pixels. So I'll type the number 5. It'll say move 5. Okay. Then, now this is important, afterwards I have to press a semicolon because Greenfoot is writing in Java, and the end of every line in Java has to be a semicolon. So now this is ready to make it do something. And so what I'm going to do, I'm going to click the close up here. The close is going to take me back here, and I'm going to click the compile. Every time I change the code, I have to click the compile. That's because we're writing in programming language, which is using English words, but computer doesn't speak English. Computer speaks binary, which is just a bunch of ones and zeros. So we have to turn it into ones and zeros the computer can understand. That's what the compile button does. So I'm going to click on compile. You'll notice everything disappears. So every time we compile, we're sort of starting all over again. So what you should do right now is you should pause it. You should go into the gold buggy code by double clicking, and you should put in move and then parentheses 5 and press the semicolon. And if you do control space, you can see your code. So put that in and then close the window and then compile it. Pause it and do that now. Okay, so you should have gone into your gold buggy window and put move inside the act method. So now we're going to put some gold buggies on here. The easiest way to do it again is just to have gold buggy selected with the dark black bar around it, then hold down the shift key so you see a gold buggy, and then I'm going to drop one. The buggies aren't gold, they're going to find gold, but we're not there yet. So, and now I'm going to click the run button, and I'm going to see my gold buggy is going to start to move. And if I click pause, it'll stop. Then I click run, and it's going to move, and then it'll hit the side of the screen, and it won't go any further. Not a very interesting game yet, because we can't really do anything except to make the car go in a straight line. But we're going to make that more interesting. What we want to do first, let's make the car turn around when it hits the side of the screen, and go in a different direction, so it'll keep on moving. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back. I'm going to go to the code editor of the gold buggy again. You can double click it. Another way to do it is I can click with my right mouse button and do open editor. That's going to do the same thing. So I'm going to do that. So pause it and open the editor, and then come back and I'll show you what we're going to do next. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to put in a conditional. A conditional means if something happens, then do something else. So the condition that we're looking for is that it's going off the map. And so the vehicle method in here has an off the map checker to see if it's going off the map. And it's going to say one of two things, true or false. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit enter. I'll hit enter one more time. And then I'm going to hit an if. I'm going to type if. Okay, we're going to use this a lot. This is saying if something happens, then do something else. So I'll type if, then I'll hit an open parentheses. So you would press shift and the 9 key. That's your open parentheses, right? And now what we need to do is we need something to come back that's either true or false. This is what's called a Boolean. A Boolean can have two values, true or false, that's going to be returned to us. And so and I'm going to need a method that's going to return that to me. So we have a method in the vehicle class that's going to tell us if it's going off the map. So I'm going to hold down control. I'm going to hit the space key. And I'm going to look, and I'm going to look for off the map. There's one called off the map. Now you'll notice here, off to the side, it says Boolean. What does that mean? That means it's going to tell me true, or if something's true or false. So I'm going to double click that. Okay. And then I'm going to click a close parenthesis. So just to explain what this means, this is saying if off the map is true, then do something. Otherwise, don't. So off the map is going to return either true or false. If it returns true, then whatever comes after this is what's going to happen. Otherwise, it's not. So we need to start a block in our if statement, and to do that I will hit the enter key, and I'm going to open a curly bracket. And to open the curly bracket, you have to press the shift and the square bracket. It's usually next to the letter P. It looks like this. And then I'm going to hit the enter key again. Now we're going to need to tell it to turn. And luckily for us, inside this vehicle class, we have a turn feature, and the turn just makes it turn a certain number of degrees. So I'm gonna, if I want to see if that method is in there, I can hit Control Space again and see all my different methods that are available. And I'm gonna go down until I see turn, and I'll click here. You'll notice return doesn't return anything, just like when you turn the steering wheel in your car, it doesn't give you anything back. All it does is make the car turn, and the turn feature does the same thing. So I'm gonna double click on that to turn that in there. And you notice in there it says amount. And so the amount here is going to be the amount of degrees we want it to turn. We're actually not going to turn it that much because what we do if we just turn it 5 degrees, it'll keep turning until it gets to where it's not running into the side of the screen anymore. So I'm going to press 5 in here. Don't forget to go after your parentheses and put in your semicolon, because once again we're in Java, everything's got to end with a semicolon. And then last of all, this is important, I have to close my if block. And I close my if block by putting a close angle bracket like this. And the close angle bracket, once again, it's right above the square bracket. It's a shift above the square bracket, which is usually above the enter key. So you'll see that right there. Okay, so now, and this is saying, so just to review what we did, this is saying if, and then we're saying off the map, which is a function that tells us if it's off the map or not, and then we're closing parentheses. We started a block, and inside the block we said turn 5, which means turn 5 degrees. We put a semicolon to close it, and then we put a curly bracket. So I want you to pause it and type what I did into your gold buggy right now, and then return, and then come back. Okay, so you should have done that now. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to close it. You'll see my gold buggy has little stripes through it. That means I've made a change, and it's going to work, not going to work right until I compile it again. So remember, every time we do something, we have to compile the thing again. So I'm going to click the compile button. Okay. I'm going to have my gold buggy selected as usual. I'll hold down the shift key, and this time I'm going to run it. And you'll notice my gold buggy this time, when it gets to a side, keeps turning and then goes around and around and around till it's not running into a side anymore. So I'll pause it now, okay? But still not that interesting, because we'd like to be able to control our little buggy by ourselves with our own computer. So let's see how we can do that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to double click on the gold buggy again. And I'm going to use a different feature, which is I'm going to use a feature from the Greenfoot that can tell us up here what the that can tell us what keys are being pressed on the keyboard. And so what we're going to do, we're going to do another if statement. And what the if statement's going to do is saying if they're pressing the left key, we're going to turn to the left. So I'm going to type if, I'm going to open parentheses, which we always do. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to type Greenfoot with a capital G. And then I'm going to do a period. Now by doing this Greenfoot period, this gives me access to all of the features that are built into Greenfoot. And I can see what they are again by hitting Control Space. And if I look here, you'll see I've got a whole bunch of different things, and we'll learn about all of them in time. The one we're looking for right now is the one that says is key down. You'll notice it returns a Boolean. A Boolean tells you if particular key is down or not. So if I want to see if the shift key is down, or if I want to see if the space key is down, I could say is key down and then the space, and it'll tell me. This string is going to, I'm going to tell it what key it's looking for. A string is the third type of variable we're going to be using a lot, the third most basic type of variable. And what the string does is that it's just a bunch of letters together. It's a word, but it just means a bunch of letters strung together. Okay, and I'll show you what a string looks like. So I'll double click here, right? You'll notice inside here it says key name. So what I have to do is put in the name of the key, and I have to put it in quote marks. Strings are always put in quote marks. So I'll do an open quote key, and then I will type left, which is the name of the left key, and then I'll do a close quote. And then I'm going to go outside, and I'm going to do a close parenthesis. So there's two parentheses here, right? I opened a parenthesis to go after the if, then I open another parenthesis to put the argument for the is key down, and then I closed the is key down argument, and then I closed the if. So we have to do the same thing we did before. We have to open a block, so we're going to do an open curly bracket. I'll hit the enter, and again, what we'll do is we'll say if the left key is down, we'll turn 5. And this time I'll just type it, because we already know what it is. I don't need to use the control space. You can just type the word turn, open parentheses, 5, and then put the, don't forget the semicolon, very important. It won't, if you'll have an error in your compiling if you forget the semicolon. And then I'm going to hit enter, and then I'm going to put a close angle bracket. You notice that when I put the close angle bracket, it unindents and moves it back. The indentation is just for us to see more clearly how the program works. The program doesn't care that much about how much things are indented, but you can see that it makes things a lot clearer to us when we have things indented, that we can see that this is all part of that is key down left block. So you should do the same thing. You should, after you pause it, type if Greenfoot, and then hit control space, pick is key down, select it, and then type left, and then close parentheses, hit enter, hit the curly brackets, type turn 5, and then hit the close curly brackets. Type all this, pause it and type all this, and then come back. Okay, so this is what you should see on your screen right now. This is what you should have. If you don't have this, you're going to want to go back and change it. If something doesn't work, it's probably because you spelled something wrong, left out a bracket, left out a semicolon, or left out a parenthesis. So check all those things if for some reason it's not working. I'll press the close key. Notice once again the Gold Buggy needs to be compiled. That's what those little slashes through it mean. So I'll press compile. And you'll notice that it compiles everything. So the Gold Buggy is now ready to work. So I'm going to put down my Gold Buggy. You'll notice it's, I have to start again and put down a new Gold Buggy. The reason I have to put down a new one every time is every time I change it, it's an object of a new different class, which is changed. Just like if you have a new, if the new iPhone comes off the assembly line, you have to go buy the new iPhone. Your old iPhone won't do what the new iPhone does until you buy the new one. So I'll press the shift and I'll put down the car. And now we can actually do something. So if I press run, and then I press my left key, I'll see my car will turn as I press the left key. So you should try that as well. Compile it, put a Gold Buggy down, and try and see if your car turns. Okay, so hopefully your car was turning. If it didn't, you should, if it didn't compile, go and look to see if you should once again go and look to see what you might be missing, see if anything spelled wrong, see if you're missing a parenthesis, seeing if you're missing a semicolon, okay, and until it works. Now, the problem with our car right now is that it only turns left, it doesn't turn right, which isn't a very useful thing for a steering wheel to do. We'd really like our car to be able to turn in both directions. So what I'd like to do is I'd like to go and I'd like to add a feature to make the car turn right. And so I'm going to add another if statement. And one thing I can do to make things a little easier is I can use the copy and paste feature. I can highlight all these lines and then I can press edit and I can do copy. Then I'll click down here, and I'll do edit, paste. Now, right now, it's the same. They're both the same thing, but I want to change it to turn right. And so what I can do is where it says left here, I'm I'm going to highlight that. Make sure not to get rid of the parenthesis, I mean, of the quote marks. Leave the quote marks in there, and I'll type right. Now, the question is, how do we make it turn right? Well, 5 degrees means 5 degrees to the left. So how do we make it turn 5 degrees to the right? What we're going to do is we're going to use a negative number. You remember when I introduced an integer, I said an integer is a negative or a positive number. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a minus sign behind the 5. So pause it and highlight the whole if statement here, including this bottom angle bracket. Copy it, change left to right, and put a minus before the 5. Okay, so if you did that, you should be back. This is what you should see on your screen. I'm going to press the close button. My gold buggy needs to be compiled again, so I'll press compile. I have to put my gold buggy down again. I'm going to press shift. I'm going to drop it. And now I'm going to run it, and my car will turn. I can make it do all kinds of things. I can turn left. I can turn right. Whee! Unfortunately, there's nothing in the desert for my car to do. It would like to grab some gold. It would like to get some gold because that's what it's here in the desert for. So I'm going to pause it, and I'm going to need to put some gold in here. Now, the gold, in this case, has to be a different sprite or a different actor in here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have to make a new subclass, and the subclass is going to be gold. And so I'm going to go up here under actor. I'm going to right click on it, and when I right click on it, and if you're using a Mac, you might have to do command click or click with both fingers to do the right click. You can go down to where it says new subclass. So what we're doing, the gold buggy already was a subclass of the actor, so we're going to make a different subclass. And when I do that, it's going to come up, and I'm going to see various choices. One of the things I have is what I have to do is I have to give it a name, and I have to give it an image. So the name, I'm going to call it gold with a capital G. This is just a convention. We name all of our classes with capital letters when we do things in Java and in Greenfoot. And if we have more than one word, we put a capital letter at the beginning of each word, the way I did with gold buggy. So I'm going to put this as gold, and then I have a little, over here I have a file, an image file, right? And that's our new class image. You'll see that's going to appear, so this is what it's going to look like when we put this actor down. Now the gold, as it is, doesn't really have to do much. It's just going to sit there and wait to be grabbed and picked up. So I don't really have to make the gold do anything at all. If I double click on it, you're going to see there's nothing here in the act method, but that's okay because it doesn't need to really do anything. It's just going to sit there. So we can leave the act method empty right now. So I will close it up, and I'm going to click compile. Okay. Now I've got two actors I can put down. So I can put my gold buggy down. I can, right? And then the other thing I can do is I can start putting some gold pieces of gold down, little piles of gold around here, right? So I'm going to put little piles of gold around. I'm going to run, and I can drive over the gold, and nothing happened because I haven't made it do anything yet. So I still have to do something to make it get the gold. So we're going to have to put in a method to make it grab the gold. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to have to go into the gold buggy, and I'm going to have to use another method to make it get the gold. And so what I'm going to do, first, now it can't get the gold unless there's some gold there, right? So we have to see if the gold is there. So we have to have another conditional. So I'm going to type an if statement. And then I'm going to do an open parentheses, and I can do control space. And I'm going to scroll down. Let me move this up a little bit so we can see it a little better. Oops. And I'm going to look for the one that says, is touching. We want to see if it's touching a particular thing. Is touching just tells you if that is something that's part of the vehicle class that tells you if it's touching something else. So if you, I'm gonna double click is touching. Now you see we have a new kind of argument here, which is class. This is a different kind of variable. It's not a basic type of variable like an integer or a string. A class is just like the things that we've been putting in. So the world is a class, the gold buggy is a class, and the gold is a class as well. So what we want to see is if it's touching this gold class. So I'm going to double click here. Now, the way I need to type this is I need to, where it's not in quote marks because this is the actual name of a class. So I'm going to type capital G-O-L-D, and then I'm going to have to type dot class. And so this is saying if it's touching something that's part of the gold class. And then I'm going to do a close parentheses. I'm going to hit the enter key. I'm going to start a block with the curly bracket as I did before. Okay, and then we're going to need a method that's going to get that thing, that's going to make it disappear, that's going to grab it. So I'm going to type get. I'm going to hit control space, and I'm going to find the thing that gets things. And you'll see there one that says get. Okay, this get just means to get something that's there, right? To grab something, right? And again, the method is the argument is class. You'll notice again, void, it doesn't return anything right now. Later on, we might change the get feature so it does return something, such as the fact that we have a piece of gold, right? We're going to make this better. Right now, it's not going to do anything. It's just going to make the gold disappear. So I'm going to double click here. Okay. And again, what it's going to get is the same thing, which is gold.class. So I'm going to type the same thing. Okay. And I'm going to hit enter, and then I'm going to hit a close curly bracket. Oops, and I almost forgot my semicolon, but we always need to put a semicolon at the end of everything that it's going to do. And so what this is going to do is it's going to grab the gold class and it's going to make it disappear. Okay, so what you should do is after you pause it, you're going to type is, and then you can hit control space to get the is touching method. And then you're going to do the open parentheses, and you'll type gold.class. Don't forget the gold is with a capital G, and then close parentheses. And then you need another close parentheses. You should have two close parentheses here. This second close parentheses, close the equal sign, put the open quote, and then put in get gold.class and the semicolon, and then the close curly bracket. So do that right now, and then come back. Okay, so I'm going to close it. I'm going to compile it. I'm going to click on the gold and I'm going to start dropping gold around here. Okay, and I'm going to put a gold buggy in here. And then I'm going to run it and I'm going to grab some gold. Woohoo! Whoops, I missed. Got one. There we go. Got another one. Oh, I missed. Got one. Got another one. Got another one. There you go. That's going to be the end of our lesson for today. So what we're going to do now is I'm going to stop. At the next lesson, I'll show you how to make this game a little bit more exciting by putting in some things that the car could crash into, so to make it a bit more of a challenge. And then later on, we'll figure out how to keep a score for how many pieces of gold we have and maybe